Hello everyone, let's begin our module 6 of the chapter number 1 from the beginning of time. This is the last module of this chapter. In this module, we are going to learn if from the lives of present hunter-gatherer society that exists in various parts of world today, we can trace the hunter-gatherers of the ancient period or the early humans. And secondly, we will be studying how the agriculture led to the revolution in the life of the early humans. Our knowledge about the present-day hunter-gatherers increased through studies by anthropologists. Anthropologists are those people who study human culture and evolutionary aspect of human biology. So, studies by anthropology, a question that began to be posed was whether the information about living hunters and gatherers could be used to understand their past societies. Currently, there are two opposing views on the same. On one side are the scholars who have directly applied specific data from present-day hunter-gatherer societies to interpret the archaeological remains of the past. Which means that basically some scholars think that yes, from the present day hunter societies, we can trace back the practices of the past hunter societies by the available archaeological evidence. So according to some scholars, they think that from the present day hunter gatherers, we can easily trace the practices of the past societies by basically properly observing the practices that are followed by the present-day hunter-gatherers. On the other side are scholars who feel that the ethnographical data cannot be used for understanding past societies as the two are totally different. For example, present-day hunter-gatherer societies pursue several other economic activities along with the hunting and gathering. These include engaging in exchange and trade in minor forest producers or working as paid laborers in the fields of neighboring farmers. Moreover, these societies are totally marginalized in all sense, geographically, politically, and socially as well. The conditions in which they are living are very different from those which used to exist for the early humans. Another problem is that there is a tremendous variation among living hunter-gathering societies. There are conflicting data on many issues such as relative importance of hunting and gathering, group sizes, or the movement from place to place. So basically they are saying that we cannot trace the past hunter-gathering societies from present-day hunter-gatherer society because today the entire scenario is different. Today they are practicing more economical activities, they have the other aspects as well. Thus, it is very difficult to actually gather information about the past hunting-gathering societies from the living hunting-gathering societies. For several million years, humans lived by hunting wild animals and gathering wild plants. Then, between 10,000 and 4,500 years ago, people in different parts of the world learned to domesticate certain plants and animals. This led to the development of farming and pastoralism as a way of life. The shift from foraging, that is, collection of just food, to farming was a major turning point in human history. The last ice age came to an end about 13,000 years ago, and with that warmer, wetter conditions prevailed. As you all know that the ice age was the period when the temperature of earth was very low and there was snow everywhere, because of which all the forest was destroyed and there were just grasslands left. So when the ice age ended, it basically created a much moderate climate which was fit for the agriculture. As a result, conditions were favorable for the growth of grasses such as white barley and wheat. At the same time, as open forest and grasslands expanded, the population of certain animal species such as sheep, goat, cattle, etc. also increased. What we find is that human societies began to gradually prefer areas that had an abundance of wild grasses and animals. Now, relatively large permanent communities occupied such areas for most parts of the year. With some areas being clearly preferred, a pressure may have built up to increase the food supply. This may have triggered the process of domestication of certain plants and animals. It is likely that a combination of factors, which included climatic change, population pressure, and a great reliance on and knowledge of a few species of plants such as wheat, barley, rice, and millet, and animals such as sheep, goat, cattle, etc., played a role in this transformation, which basically means that from the early nomadic life, now they are moving in a life that is settled by living at a particular place. Farming and pastoralism led to the introduction of many other changes, such as making of pots in which to store grains and other produce and to cook food. Besides, new kind of stone tools came into use. Other new tools such as plow were used in agriculture. Gradually, people became familiar with metals such as copper and tin. Another important change was the invention of the wheel, which was important for both pot making and transportation came into use. So these are the various factors and the various developments that basically changed the entire scenario of the early hunter-gatherers. In our next chapter, we will be basically dealing about the first civilization of which we have the evidences, where we find the agriculture was practiced the first. And we will learn how from early humans a whole civilization came into being.